Hi everybody, Scott Card here, and welcome back to my lab. Today I have for you a presentation on hot air soldering that I hope you enjoy. All right? Welcome back everybody. This board is something that I came up with. It's a development board to work on a switch mode power supply, a very simple, older style chip. It's a MC34063, and I've developed it for my students to help them learn how to do surface mount soldering. And so in this case, you can see that I've gone and manually put the solder on using just the tube. There's way too much solder. I get that. I understand. But the great thing is that I want you to notice it doesn't really matter. Even the placement of these components, while I do take a little bit of care to place them, you're going to see them pull into place quite nicely. And these are large components, relatively speaking. They're SOD123, they're 1206, they're quite large. But, you know, we're able to just place them, and you're going to see when we do actually start heating them up that they're going to pull into place because of the surface tension. So here's a capacitor. You can see that I have been careful watching polarity on the important components, and those that aren't, we don't really care. Here's a smaller component. This is, I believe it's an 0603. I'm back to 1206, a nice resistor. And I won't bore you with all of the components, but it, you know, here's a nice group of them. Okay. Nice little LED, super bright little guy. And an SO8 package. And again, you notice it's sloppy. It is crazy sloppy, and it really doesn't matter. And one of the reasons why it doesn't matter is because I do have good solder with a good flux in it. And here we are, we're heating it up. Notice that I do keep the soldering iron a fair distance away. It's set about 375 degrees Celsius, and the air flow is set to minimum. With the largest nozzle I have, and you see that I just go around and I gently heat it until it flows. Okay, and the nice thing is that as it flows, right, once you get both leads wetted, it'll pull right into place nicely. And here we are again. So now we've got the resistor and that SO8 package. And I'm heating it slowly. I don't want to blow any parts away, and I also don't want to overheat anything. And so, gently warming that SO8 package and the 0.62 ohm resistor and behind it R2 heats up just naturally. And here we go. That's all done, all wetted perfectly. And we can get the components beside it. And one of the tricks is to make sure that we're letting the heat flow. So we don't want to randomly go across the board. We want to use the heat in the board to preheat it, so to speak. So as we're going in a pattern. Okay. And so again, you can see they pull in. And on top of R1, there is a solder blob there, but that's okay. Here we are, we're zoomed in to the point where you can actually see the grains of solder in the flux. Okay, and as it heats up, yeah, okay, so that that one blob on top kind of sucks up on itself, and you can see that the other main components, they do heat up nicely and flow, and then you can see that it goes from that nice shiny to a dull as it freezes. Okay, there they are, they're all frozen, and we're all set. Okay, hopefully this video was helpful and entertaining. If it was, please give it a thumbs up, like and subscribe if you'd like to be made aware when I make more videos like this, and as always, thanks for watching. Have a great day. All right, bye now.